This is the BBC.
This podcast is supported by advertising outside the UK.
Tired of ads interrupting your gripping investigations? Good news. Ad-free listening on Amazon Music is included with your Prime membership. Ads shouldn't be the scariest thing about true crime. Just head to amazon.com/adfreetruecrime to catch up on the latest episodes without the ads.
Enjoy thousands of Acast shows ad-free for Prime subscribers. Some shows may have ads.
Hey, I'm Ryan Reynolds. At Mint Mobile, we like to do the opposite of what Big Wireless does. They charge you a lot, we charge you a little. So naturally, when they announced they'd be raising their prices due to inflation, we decided to deflate our prices due to not hating you. That's right. We're cutting the price of Mint Unlimited from $30 a month to just $15 a month. Give it a try at mintmobile.com/switch.
$45 up front for 3 months plus taxes and fees. Promo rate for new customers for limited time. Unlimited more than 40 gigabytes per month slows. Full terms at mintmobile.com.
BBC Sounds. Music, radio, podcasts.
BBC Radio 2. 10 to the top.
So it's the last 10 to the top of the week. My last 10 to the top for a little while because Vern's going to be back on Monday. So let's hope it's a really high-scoring competition today. Clare Farron in Wigan. You feeling confident of a high score?
Oh, you've put a bit of pressure on me there, Gary. I think any score I'll be grateful for at this moment.
Putting loads of pressure on you today.
Yeah.
So it's Big 5-0 for you this year.
It is. There I am broadcasting it on national radio.
It's okay, we won't tell anybody. When is it?
Mine's not till October.
Right.
So we've got my husband's before that. So yeah, we've got a few things lined up to celebrate that.
So you and Lawrence planning big celebrations this year?
We are, yeah. We've got a little sailing trip planned for the summer.
Ooh.
So yeah, that's our main thing at the minute.
Where are you going to be sailing?
Was it going to go to Greece? So yeah, he did his wet sailing qualifications last year. So yeah, he's going to be sailing us around some of the Greek islands.
So newly qualified, you're going to trust him?
Yes. He's pretty good.
What could possibly go wrong? So you're going to go sailing around Greece, but you're a Spanish teacher.
I am. Yeah, I teach in a school in Liverpool, teach all boys. Mm-hmm. Try and influence them a little bit with music as well where I can. So yeah, we usually drop a few little references into the lessons, introduce them to Lionel Richie a couple of weeks ago. So, yeah.
Yeah, you're bringing them up right. I like that.
Absolutely, yeah.
Okay, well, we better get down to business. Going to have a nice high-scoring round for you.
Oh, as I said to one of your team earlier, if I score right now, that's the main thing.
Well, just 1 point, you'd be happy.
Yeah, right now, just to get something on the board.
All right, you ready?
Okay, yeah, let's do it.
To the top on Radio 2.
For 1 point, which you will be happy with. On their 1978 number one, the Commodores said, "You're once, twice, what?"
Three times a lady.
Three times a lady. You got your point.
Yes.
Okay, have a listen to this. And we also wish happy birthday to Chris Stein from Blondie. This 1981 song reached the UK top five for the band and went to number one in America. But what's the title? What's that called?
Rapture.
You got two right now. 3 points on this next one.
Okay, I think I'm going to play it safe and play my joker here.
Okay. This is worth 6 points. Good luck, Claire.
Okay.
Left to My Own Devices was a top 10 hit in 1988. For which duo?
Pet Shop Boys.
Ooh. Yes.
Oh.
It was the Pet Shop Boys. Took some thinking, that, didn't it?
It did. It did. I was singing it in my head. Thankfully, not aloud.
Well, you got a six-pointer. Well done. Way more than 1 point for you.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
And this next question's worth four. Who was at number one on the chart exactly 5 years ago with the song Sweet But Psycho?
Rita Ora. Ava Max.
Yeah, it was Ava Max. You knew it. Drat.
Yeah.
Never mind. Let's build you up again. For 1 point, which rock band, fronted by Brian Molko, had top 10 entries in 1998 with the songs Pure Morning and You Don't Care About Us?
No idea. Nine Inch Nails.
Placebo.
Okay. Never going to get that one.
Yeah.
Right.
For a point, in 1990, the group Partners in Crime spent a month at number one with which song?
No idea again, Gary.
No.
No, never heard of them.
Well, you clearly played your joker at the right time. That's a good thing.
Yeah.
Turtle Power. Was it the Ninja Turtle song?
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, still for a point. There was a new number one exactly 30 years ago this week, and it was a cover of a familiar classic. But who is performing it? Who's that?
Shaggy.
Do you know what? I understand why you say Shaggy, but it wasn't. It was Chakademus and Pliers.
Oh, Chakademus and Pliers. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, it was a tune that the Beatles used to cover at the end of their gigs in the early 60s, and they came to know the song through the version that the Isley Brothers made in 1962.
Okay.
For 1 point, in 1979... The Dickies reached the top 10 with a punk version of which kids' TV theme? The Dickies.
Oh, the Muppets?
No. But I love all your guesses. It was Banana Splits.
Okay.
All right. Still for 1 point, give me the one-word title of the 1989 single that put the Lightning Seeds into the top 40 for the first time.
Pure.
Yeah.
Yes.
And your final question for 2 points. Sign of the Times was the debut solo hit for Harry Styles. And it went straight in at number one. But in which year?
2018.
1 year out, 2017. Oh. You only wanted 1 point and you got 10.
Oh, do you know what? I'm happy with that. Double figures, what more can I ask for?
You had a great start and then it rapidly went downhill.
It did, didn't it?
But 10's okay. 10 could be a winning score. Well, depending on how Andrew Chipchase does in Whitley Bay, because he's coming up next.
From a talent show become a worldwide phenomenon.
There was a really hungry fan base.
Changing the face of fandom forever.
There was just fans that literally were stopping us even getting to the studio.
I'm Maddie Grace Jepson, and with the people who made them.
That boy band really has something.
And the people who loved them.
Sit outside Niall Horan's house for 6 hours just to catch a glimpse of the top of his hair.
There's just a fire within teenage girls.
This is One Direction, a fan story. Listen on BBC Sounds.
Andrew Chase is contestant number two. He's in Whitley Bay. Good morning.
Good morning, Gary. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you too. How are you doing?
Yeah, we're all good. Looking forward to the quiz.
Oh, good.
Nice to be on this time of year.
You're a big caravaner.
Yeah. We're very lucky. We've got the northeast and the northeast coast and the northwest not too far away. We're very lucky.
So you have your own caravan?
Yeah. We had motorhomes before we had the kids, and then we've got the caravan now. But my wife, my kids, my three kids and the dog all fit in snugly.
Where's the nicest place you've taken it?
Oh, we love going to the lakes, the Lake District in the northwest, Gary. I know you're a Man United fan, so you might be up here now and again, but it's just the most beautiful area in the world, and the kids enjoy it. It's lots of fresh air, lots of family time, and we do. We're going at the weekend, actually, for my daughter's birthday.
Oh, it just sounds gorgeous. And you take the caravan to music festivals. I like that.
Well, we did our first family festival last year because the kids are just about getting old enough to like last the whole day. And it was like a 90s revival one in Newton Aycliffe. There was Cast on and there was Dodgy on. And so it was good what like the kids getting the chance to see what their mum and dad used to listen to when they were a little bit younger.
Did they appreciate it?
Well, my daughter, Ida, had her first concert with her mum last year, and she went to go and see Pulp in their in their new kind of guys in Scarborough, and that was her first ever gig, so it's not a bad place to start. So we're bringing them up right.
Yeah, you definitely are. All right then, 10 to beat. How did you get on with Claire's questions?
I got 10 as well, so we'll have to see how we get on.
Okay. All right, good luck. Here we go. Question one, for 1 point. Christa Berg spent 3 weeks at number one in 1986 with which song?
Lady in Red.
It was the Lady in Red. You have 1 point. You have 2 points available on this next question. Rabbit was a top 10 hit in 1981 for which Cockney duo?
Chaz and Dave.
Yep. It was Chaz and Dave.
More rabbit than Sainsbury's.
Absolutely. It's a great line, isn't it? 3 points on this. I Wrote a Song was the UK's Eurovision entry last year, and it then became a top 10 hit for May who?
Was it Burton?
It was May Muller.
May
Muller, I Wrote a Song. Back down to 1 point, I'm afraid. But we can build it up again. Have a listen to this. In 1992, Bob Marley and the Wailers reached the top five with this posthumous hit. Just give me the three-word rhyming title. What's the title?
Haven't got a clue, Gary. Haven't got a clue.
No. Oh. It was Iron Lion Zion.
Oh, that's the one, yeah.
Yeah, it was pieced together using an old cassette demo that was discovered by accident almost a decade after Bob Marley's death. And it became it became his biggest hit since One Love in 1984. Still for a point, which legendary American rock band took their song Riders on the Storm into the chart in both 1971 and 1976?
That was The Doors.
It was The Doors. 2 points on this next one. People Every Day in 1992 and Mr. Wendell in 1993 were both huge hits for which group?
Arrested Development.
Ah, you're on a nice little roll now. Well done. 3 points on this next question. In what year did INXS reach the top three with their song Need You Tonight?
1989.
Oh!
88.
It was 88.
Oh, no.
OK, another music clip for you. Here's a feel-good party tune from this week's top three exactly 45 years ago. Can you name the group performing it?
Come on, baby, lay your love on me.
What's the name of that group?
Shawaddy Waddy.
I understand why you said that, because it does sound quite Shawaddy Waddy-ish, but it wasn't. It was Racy.
Yeah.
Racy and Lay Your Love on Me. Their follow-up hit was Some Girls, which also reached the top three. Yeah, yeah. Two more questions. You still got a joker. This is for 1 point. Which US R&B star topped the chart in 2012 with his song Let Me Love You, brackets, Until You Learn to Love Yourself?
Akon?
Neo.
Crikey.
Yeah. Hey! 2-pointer coming up. What time of the day did DJ and producer ATB reference in the title of his 1999 number one single?
Here we go. Is it 9 p.m. till I come?
9 p.m. till I come, absolutely. Andrew, you got 8 points.
Oh, no. Never mind.
So close.
Oh, well.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much anyway. Well done to Clare. Yeah.
Oh, you almost did it.
It was one of those, wasn't it? Yeah, a couple of ones either there, but it happens.
Yeah, but you get yourself a Radio 2 mug, 10 to the top mug.
Oh,
we'll get
that
on the way to you.
Thank you so much.
It's been lovely speaking to you. Well done, Andrew.
All right, well, have a lovely new year, everyone. Thank you.
And well done, Clare.
Oh, thank you, Gary. What a great start to my big year.
10 points is a winning score today.
Oh, brilliant.
Yeah.
I'm made up with that.
And you get yourself a Radio 2 smart speaker.
Oh, very exciting. Thank you. Thank you very much.
But listen, happy birthday for later in the year to you and Lawrence.
Thank you.
All the best.
All right, thank you. Take care.
Cheers. Bye. So well done, Clare, and bad luck to Andrew. Two more brilliant contestants taking on 10 to the top. Are you tempted to have a go? Maybe your New Year's resolution was to take on a new challenge like Clare, and you haven't thought of one yet. Well, maybe it should be 10 to the top. If you want to play and you fancy trying to win that smart speaker, the team are ready and waiting for your application. Just email 10tothetop@bbc.co.uk with your name, contact details, and why you're the right person to play. Or you can register to play by sending a message to the Radio 2 WhatsApp number. That's 08000 288 291. Come on, have a go.
10 to the top on Radio 2.
BBC Sounds. Music, radio, podcasts.
Tired of ads barging into your favorite news podcasts? Good news. Ad-free listening on Amazon Music is included with your Prime membership. Just head to amazon.com/adfreenewspodcasts to catch up on the latest episodes without the ads. Enjoy thousands of Acast shows ad-free for Prime subscribers. Some shows may have ads.